Learn how to fix an unreachable VM in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. So let's suppose we have an Azure VM running with a public IP address and a website on the Azure VM at the IP address. What if one day we see the website refuses to connect and no amount of refreshing will do anything? Well, we'd probably go back to the VM and we'd probably try to SSH in to see what's wrong. But in this case, SSH doesn't seem to be doing anything. We're not able to SSH in. What would you do? Well, thankfully, Azure has a Serial Console feature, which allows you to connect to the VM, even in these network connectivity issue cases. So let's go to the Serial Console. So as you can see, we were able to connect to the Serial Console of the VM. This is because the Serial Console here connects to the virtualized serial port on the VM, so it's unaffected by lack of SSH or any other connectivity. As you can see here, the VM has dropped us into emergency mode, so something has gone wrong. Let's log in and investigate. So a lot of emergency mode scenarios happen when the OS can't boot, and this is often because of a faulty fstab file. Let's check it out. As you can see, there's an erroneous entry here. It's got a UID of 1 and it's trying to mount that at foo. So clearly this is wrong. There's one thing I want to call out, and it's that when you add an entry into fstab, you can actually avoid these boot failures by adding a no-fail option at the end of the defaults line here. Just like that. This will tell the OS to continue booting even if mounting fails. However, we know this line is just plain wrong, so we can delete it. Now let's reboot the VM and see what happens. Now we can see that the boot was successful because we were presented by a proper login prompt. Now let's go to the web page here and refresh it. And as you can see, this was successful and we can see that the web app has loaded. So in this video, we debugged a web app that was failing to load by using the Azure Serial Console to connect to the VM when SSH wasn't available. We used the Serial Console to fix an erroneous fstab entry and then successfully rebooted the VM and we were able to load up our website.